kiss you, sir.
Burnham Burgess is still Skint.
Kiss you, boys and girls. Yeah.
Hey. He might have become a celebrity in his hometown of Birmingham.
Skint.
They've got fans everywhere now. It's good, isn't it?
But he's still selling the big issue for a living.
I've got enough for a couple of joints.
Vernon's had a tough year. He's been living rough again. And last Christmas was one to forget.
I was in hospital last Christmas and missed last Christmas. This section, man, there was nothing wrong with me.
This year, he's determined that things will be different. He's got 100 new schemes to make money.
He's got a toaster sign for having a hot dog.
A toaster?
And music might just be his salvation. Burnham Burgess is busking for Christmas because he knows how hard it can be when you're skint.
Yeah, there's a lot of things happen to me in my life. I've got more and more to this fight than much they are.
This is him, look, here he is.
Over the summer, Vernon's been taking guitar lessons from his friend, Trev.
He's ever such a nice lad, he's ever such a nice man. I met him when I was doing the big issue at the supermarket. Oh, really? And I've been having guitar lessons off him, like. And I'm getting a bit better. I actually earned £47 busking the other day. So, like, yeah, I'm going to see you.
Vernon's got another lesson today. There's only one problem.
Getting a guitar lesson. The thing is, I haven't got my guitar today. I've had a flood at my daughter's and it's stuck in there.
What are we going to do? You're
gonna I'll sit and watch you play some chords tonight and see if I can pick up on it.
Right, where are we going?
In the garden. Yeah. I practiced that knocking on heaven's door.
Trevor is a man of many talents. Musician, comedian, and impressionist.
Okay, so yeah, I'm a Donovan impersonator and I'm called Vano Don. Anyway, this song goes like this. I know quite a few Donovan songs, which I teach. Very, very basic chords.
Yeah.
But
we've actually played Donovan
with a C.
Episode, okay.
And a F.
Yeah. F. C.
And a
G.
G.
I'll do a G.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know the song?
I'm not
sing
sure.
Along if you know the words. Oh. I'm just mad about saffron.
Saffron's mad about me. I'm just mad about saffron. And she's just mad about me. The curly mellow yellow. The curly mellow yellow.
Quite frankly.
Yeah! Mellow yellow!
Twice nightly.
Yeah.
Even with Trev's teaching, Vernon's had mixed fortunes with his busking so far.
That was the bongo drum I was practicing on yesterday. They said I was making too much noise at the supermarket where they wouldn't allow me to play. They said I can come up there with the guitar but not the bongo drums. The cashier couldn't take any more, so they stopped me.
Trev, I've got to shoot off now and get some bigger shoes sold.
Okay.
As otherwise, I'm going to get. Yeah. Money for today.
I'll see you, Vernon. 100% good vibes.
100% good vibes. All the
way. For that, Katie, because you don't king swear.
The big issue has always been a lifeline for Vernon, and he's a familiar face at the Birmingham office.
I'm going to buy £30 worth, but
he's buying magazines at cost price, keeping any profit he makes for himself.
£35 gets me 50 magazines, so I'll get 50. £35. Can't go wrong there.
And what will you make on that?
I'll make about £1 or something. No, £80 or something. Well, I'll make a profit. Yeah. Because I'm on top of famous now, people ask me to autograph the big issues. Like, will you autograph it for me, Vernon? I've put, who's it to? I put Love Vernon off Skint, 2005 to 2007. And it seems to go down well with my customers. Like, everyone's happy.
Yeah, I've got my
magazine. I'll just
cover
this week. I'm soon to cover this week. Is that Ozzy? Is that Ozzy Osbourne? Yeah, it's Ozzy. They said to Ozzy, don't you watch Coronation Street and EastEnders anymore, Ozzy? And he says, no, he watches Skint.
Awesome.
Busking would be a valuable source of income, if he can get hold of a guitar. Fortunately, one of his biggest fans is coming to the rescue.
Busking.
No problem, mate.
Nice one. This is Gary Brunsdale.
How are you?
Not so bad, bro. Not so bad.
Good today, yeah?
Yeah, things are all right today. I had my injection yesterday. Oh, God bless you, Gary. No, so I'll get some busking done now.
No problem, mate.
As long as we've lads get out so I can do some busking, Mark.
Vernon, for me and for a lot of Birmingham people, he's the face of Birmingham. This is what you call salt of the earth. Do you know what I mean? He don't ask for much. You know what I mean? He's just his own self, man. And to still have a smile on his face like that, he's totally amazing.
Right, so I've got a few as well. I'll pop over and see you later.
Yeah. Just take care of that.
I will do, guys. So sad. I will do.
Don't take it to cash.
All right. All right. It's all right.
Long distance information. Give me Memphis, Tennessee. Help me find.
God bless you, Lillian. Thank you. Help me find the party. God bless you. See you on the box, Bob. Thank you.
Vernon's back on the street with a working guitar. Well, almost.
How do you do, boys and girls? Look at this. I'm missing a string. I can only do the one or two songs. I know. I broke a string, so I've got the money now to buy a string. I'm going to get one from Cash Converters now. They only charge a pound. And then there's a chubby in the Cancer Research Shop, or out of the Aged, I think it is. One of the research shops. They're £3.99, a brown one, and it's nice, so I'll get that. And a string. Just a few more quid I need. A few more dollars. See what I can do. Anything I can do, lads? Her even drops on the cheek. Oh, God bless you, pal. Nice struggle. Thanks a lot, lad. Thank you, lad. Anything you'll do, boys and girls.
The police bring Vernon's gig to a premature end. It's against the law to busk without a licence. And to get one, Vernon has to pass an audition judged by the local council.
The police says no until I get a busker's licence. I can't do busking. Well, I've got my money from my hat and my guitar string, so I made it. They're ever so nice about it, though. But like I said, I want you to see the British police in action.
So I'll get a string, who's got one here. Is Tony here, mate?
Vernon's always relied on buyback stores. They accept almost anything as security, giving customers 28 days to buy their goods back at a higher price.
He always sorts me out, this bloke. He's a good lad. My still string.
For those on the breadline, they offer a vital source of funds.
Because you can't eat gold and you can't eat video recorders when you've got no food. So, like, it has to go. Something has to go when you're on benefits. I mean, to say living on benefits is... It's not easy, mate. Do you know what I mean? It's not easy.
There you go.
Oh, God. Have you seen that, Tony?
Don't worry about it.
Oh, God bless you, Tony. Thanks so much a lot, Tony. No, thanks, Tony. He's a good right. Lad. So, Tony, thanks ever such a lot. Right. See you again.
See you again.
Oh, that sounds good to me. I should be able to earn some money with that now, shouldn't I?
I think it's Bernardo's.
There's one last purchase to top off Vernon's busking act.
So Phil Beatty is. Oh, it's still there. Oh, that's brilliant. See if it fits again, still. Yeah, that fits me. That's the one I was after. Look, it's a really good mic as well. Christie's of London. No. I'll drop the money in that one, on. Yeah. You're all right now.
Back at his flat, and with a music icon watching over him, Vernon's getting excited by the idea of going legit as a busker.
Hey, the king. If I get my busker's license, I'll be so happy. I mean, the copper said to me, you get a busker's license, Vernon, and you can bust till your heart content. That'd be all right, wouldn't it? I'll get a few quid then, like. Make some proper money then. Yeah, I'm just getting in the bath then. Tell you what, for 42, I've got a good head of hair there, don't I? I've got me Bob Marley t-shirt.
Vernon's also got a good head for figures when it comes to wheeling and dealing.
Got a £1 over the road. I've got a confession to make. I was buying bottles of aftershave for £1 each, selling them 3 for a tenner.
It worked, it was going on hot cakes. Down boy, down boy. God, the customers are stringing me up if they knew that, wouldn't they? And DVDs, I was buying for £1 and selling them through for £0.01. You've got to make a living somehow, haven't you?
Vernon constantly hustles for a living as he struggles to chip away at his biggest problem, debt. In the past, he tried to launch a pop music career, but that just left him owing even more money.
£544.88. So I don't know what I'm going to do about it. It's really worrying. What am I going to do if the bar lifts come?
So he's got to keep busking. Until he applies for a license, he'll just have to hope that the police are in the mood for a song.
Anything will do, boys and girls. Absolutely anything will do, folks. Does anybody need another $1 million star? Does anybody need to be told over and over?
Anything will do, boys and girls, running off skins. Anything will do, folks. It was out of necessity having to do it. I learned to play a bit, I've only touched the tip of the iceberg on playing guitar. You don't get nothing if you don't get off your backside, you sit on your backside, you're going to get nothing, are you?
God bless you, Angel. You are good.
Busking brings in some much needed cash. And he knows exactly how to make the most of his earnings.
I earned another £10 busking, and I've got a couple of quid as well, silver. So I've got about £12 what I've made today in Kingsleith, and I'm going to go and buy some big issues now. Because if I spend the tenner or the money, then it'll fit on a couple of electric, it'd go. So it's £3 to go on electric. But we'll have £7 for food, and we'll be on our arse again. But I'm going to put the lot now on bigger shoes.
No problem.
I don't know if you can count this, how much I got.
How many are you having?
As many as I can get. I've got about 10 or 12 pounds.
Oh.
That's really brilliant.
Vernon's about to leave when he recognises a face and gets a shock.
Oh, Vernon.
Yeah, isn't he nice? He's good.
Yeah.
Oh, bless him. God, I know him very well.
Did you?
Yeah.
Is it alright, Ben?
Yeah, it's a bit of a shock. It wasn't right, for real. It's not just something that wasn't right. I'll be okay, though. Fucking hell. Never mind. He's not suffering anymore, is he?
No. Do you want to take a bit of time out?
Yeah, that's give me a bit of a shock, that did, bro, because he was really my friend. So tragic, really, isn't it? You know, another young person died, another young life. But yeah, you can guarantee, like, he probably OD'd. Yeah. I'm going to go off and sell those big issues then, bro. Yeah, man.
The death of a friend is a stark reminder of the tough reality of life when you're skint.
I'm sick of fucking life, mate, I tell you. Get a bit depressed sometimes. Yeah, a bit under the weather, mate. Pissed off with big issue and pissed off with busking. Pissed off with having no money. Pissed off with living in a crummy little council flat. I'm fed up of it. I've had enough of it, mate. Fucking nightmare. People saying, you know, you fucking homeless and stuff, that's right to me. Some comments to get off people.
From
passers-by? From passers-by, yeah. It fucking does your head in. And then they just blank you. And it's like you're fucking begging for their money, man. It's horrible. It's fucking horrible. It's a nightmare. And the big issue is a fucking nightmare. There was a piece on it, the big issue, vendors run the gauntlet. Do you know what I mean? It's a fucking nightmare.
Vernon's own troubles began in earnest in 1985, when he was wrongfully arrested for a notorious crime, the murder of a young woman on a London to Birmingham train.
That guy pulled up and saw her, jumped out and arrested him, and said, "You're under arrest for murder, suspicion of murder, you know." And then I went from the special courts that day, that afternoon, from special courts, right, off to Brockhill, and off to the hospital wing to a padded cell. I spent 3 months, 12 weeks in there.
The arrest contributed to the mental health issues he has struggled with to this day.
I've had the old fucking trolley. I've had every sort of fucking drug in the psychiatric trolley. Clopromazine, Largactyl, Droperidol. I've had the fucking lot, mate. All sorts of shit. It's supposed to be a fucking hospital and make you worse in there. You come out like a nutter. I just took off my fucking north a while.
Vernon still goes to hospital every month to get injections that help regulate his behaviour.
Oh, five.
The staff know him well.
Got a birthday card. Got one with a £10 voucher in. After myself too, for my birthday. I was 42 the other day, like. That's nice of him, ain't it?
That's brilliant.
So I'm going to spend that on some cigarettes for myself at the co-op, and I've got another card as well. Look out, here comes another birthday. Of Stephen Dye, insane. That's the mental health team, the CPNs and that. They always give me a card every year, but they're not allowed to give cash anymore. But she's made it out to the co-op so I can still get my cigarettes.
So, how are you feeling?
Really great, I've had a jab. I've had my jab, like 200 milligrams, I've had it reduced again. So it's a sign I'm getting really well.
Exactly.
Just calms me down a bit. It's an antipsychotic drug. So, like, keeps me well.
He's in the mood for reminiscence. And in honour of his birthday, we spent a few days taking him round some of his old haunts. Starting with the place where it all began.
City Hospital, Dudley Road Hospital, Birmingham, Winston Green. This is where I was born, like. This is where I was born. This is the school I attended from about 1970 to 1974. We've seen the old drain pipe. She would climb up the drain pipe onto the school roof. And I managed to get on the school roof. And I was about five. It's a nightmare, I was a little terror, I was.
I had my baptism just there. Dude?
Yeah?
Father O'Donnell baptised me, an Irish priest he was from Ireland. And yeah, I was done my baptism and then I was done my confirmation 4 years later when I was about 14 in this church. I used to come here with my mother, I did, and all my school friends. So a lovely statue of Our Lady.
I believe in a God of love, a God of forgiveness, God of power. Same as everyone else is, God, there's only one God. There's many different religions, but there's only one God. Do you know?
I mean, yeah, I haven't been quite a good lad myself in my life. I've been a bit of a sinner, mate.
Story of God is in Latin there.
The parish priest is impressed by how much Vernon remembers of his religious education.
Nil nisi crus, it means nothing without the cross. I remember that.
That's
a school.
That's wonderful. You're the first person that has explained it to me.
Yeah. I remember. Oh, Father Sam. Thank you. Sam.
God bless. Sam. God bless.
Sam, I'm back in the car, lads. This is where I was brought up, yeah? Round here. That's my old house here, love. Still got the same chimney pot, but what we left.
Childhood homes bring the memories flooding back. especially of Christmas.
Yeah, and this is the one, Christmas and everything. Me and my sister used to play in the attic. I used to have to play dolls with her in the attic up there, feeding Smarties to the dolls through the hole under the doll's mouth that had been made and shoving Smarties in. And I hated it. I did play dolls with my sister. I hated it. But, yeah.
Do you remember any Christmas presents you got?
A cine camera with cartoons on it off my sister, Sheila. And I used to climb up the top of the larder, because you'd have a larder in those days, you know. So I'd be up there in the larder with this little projection camera, watching cartoons. It was probably the best Christmas box I'd got in my childhood.
There's time for one last stop. The psychiatric hospital where Vernon spent a Christmas he'd rather forget.
Spent last Christmas in there? Yeah. Yeah. We had lots of food laid on that, we did. Christmas dinner and everything. But, like, I had an altercation with the police in Nottingham because I'd been mugged and I had no money and I was trying to get a travel warrant out of the police to get back to Birmingham because I was stranded. And they sectioned me. Mental health come up on the computer and the police sectioned me. Yeah, it was all right. I was glad to get out, I tell you.
Come away. Come away, we'll go to anywhere in Albion.
Vernon's chances of a better Christmas this year depend on his success as a busker. He's low on funds and light bulbs.
One blue last night. I've got three bulbs to me nine. But yeah, here they are. Hey! So, like, I bought a couple of supplies for myself, you know. Oh, that's just gone. It's just gone. We'll have to go do it in the living room, won't we? Is this bright enough?
But he's finally got hold of the form he needs to apply for a busker's licence.
So, like, I've got my application forms through to be a busker, to get a busker's licence. Birmingham City Council application form to be a busker. Hey, so we've got to fill it in. Where it's got to get sent to?
Yeah.
Right. What will you stick a stamp on it for me?
Yeah.
Oh, you're a good one.
Until the council decide whether to offer Vernon an audition, it's back to the streets. And this time, he's got help.
Oh, hello, folks. I'm going to cash my weekly money, go and get me 67 quid. And I'm going to buy bigger shoes with it. Same as last week. This is my friend Lila. She's from Aberdeen in Scotland.
Dundee.
She did live in Aberdeen one time, yeah.
I've been there.
Been there.
Next one up. Scotland, yeah.
Vernon's promised Lila half the profits of any sales. She depends on the big issue. She can't claim benefits because she hasn't got a bank account or an address.
And you're not getting any benefits.
No, I'm not. I'm not claiming at the moment. NFA. No fixed abode. No effing address, as I say. But yeah, so I got that used to just selling the issues.
66 quid.
That's all right.
Yeah, it's all right. Let me get some issues with that.
They could make a decent profit if they sold all their big issues. But the weather isn't doing them any favours.
Well, I want to get out of the rain for a bit. I wait till it stops raining, then vend or something.
Have a nice night.
Can't really vend in this weather, though. I can't really vend in this weather. Yeah. Not the rain coming down. You get soaked to the skin, and on. That's pneumonia.
Mm. Oh, no.
Enjoy the issue. Thank you.
Vernon's had enough. But Layla's persistence has paid off.
Still wet, but I've finished them. It's just two last week's. Done them. I just got the two wet ones left. Yeah, that's all right. Made up for being bloody. Hopefully tomorrow will be drier.
Yeah, we'll start some more. We've got plenty of mags for tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm. Next day, there was no sign of the profits that Layla had been promised. And no sign of Vernon, either.
Well, I lent Vernon some money, and he was supposed to get some big issues and come back, and he didn't come back. And that left me a bit short, because I only lent him the money on the condition. He says, that's the money for issues tomorrow. And he says, don't worry, I'll go out and sell the ones that's left in the morning, get the office and come back. But he didn't come back, and I've had a cold as well because I got soaked in the rain. So I'm a bit, I am literally skinned right now. Hello?
When we finally track him down, Layla demands an apology.
He's saying something about he'll be able to sort me out when he gets paid or something, but I'm not 100% sure when that's going to be. At least he said sorry.
Vernon might have made it up with Layla, but for the next few weeks, he decided to lie low.
The falling leaves drift by the window.
The autumn leaves. We searched his usual haunts with no luck.
Saturday night.
Did he say where he
was going to sell? I see. Pitch where he was working before. I think that was insane. Sainsbury. The summer
kisses. No, nothing outside Sainsbury. The sunburned hands
I used to hold. Even Trevor had heard nothing from his pupil and was worried that he'd taken refuge in a dark place.
Where do you reckon he might be?
Well, it could be any one of 100 places, really, you know. As to what he's doing, I really couldn't, you know, I wouldn't like to guess. But I miss you most. When autumn leaves begin to fall.
Exactly.
But I miss you most of all, my Vernon. When autumn leaves start to fall.
Start to fall.
When Vernon finally surfaced, it was clear his spirits were low.
This is Vicky.
Hi, Miss Skint.
So where have you been?
Oh, just come out to stop at my own place, like, you know what I mean? Just on my own a bit, yeah.
With Christmas approaching, money worries are weighing heavily on his mind. And the authorities have lost patience with his busking.
Yeah, I mean, if Kingsley's police wasn't so fucking a bit more lenient with buskers, I could go and earn some money. It's other areas of the same. We went to Saudi all the other week and we got stopped. I'm skint and I'm pissed off. And I'm skint and I'm skint.
Well, why are you pissed off?
Well, I got no money. I can't get no fucking shopping in today for the kids or whatever. I haven't got any money, have I?
They're looking at Christmas presents from the £1 shop, really.
Yeah, but we're not fucking... Don't celebrate Christmas. Christmas is for the fucking rich, isn't it?
Christmas has often been a struggle for Vernon. And last year wasn't the only time he was separated from family and friends.
It was Christmas in prison. And the food was real good. We had turkey and pistols carved out of wood. And I dream of...
Well, I got into a fight about 20 years ago. And I was attacked with a knife. And he come at me to cut me with a knife again. For no apparent reason, I've been set about it, like, in a pub in the hallway. But I was in a pub where it was just... Not my community to go to, like, you know what I mean? It wasn't my patch to go on. And they must have took unkindly to me, but he cut me with a knife. And anyway, I had to smash my lager bottle to try and defend myself because he was serious. I was getting cut with a knife. I got half scalped. Well, I got 3 years for that.
Vernon was behind bars in the late 80s, and he'll never forget it.
And I'd have to scrub floors and clean floors. And clean the cells out, clean all the cells out, behind the strip cells, the normal cells, the hospital wing cells, clean them all out, scrub all the floors. You have to have them spotless, clean the walls and that, and get them all spotless and make the beds, make sure it's got all the stuff in the cell what a prisoner uses, like the knife, fork, spoon and mug.
Unless you want to come in places like this, you just got to behave yourself, lads, honestly. Unless you want to come in and here all your life, in and out. Some people don't break the cycle. Well, I never went back, and I'll never go back to prison, unless I get a job as a prison officer.
It's Christmas in prison. There'll be music tonight. I'll probably get homesick. I'll love you. Good night.
With no money and mounting debts, Vernon's prospects of a better Christmas this year seem slim. Then he gets some good news. The council have offered him an audition.
Frodo, last hand. Where am I going to do it? HMV, yeah. Yeah, I'll be there for that, like. That's brilliant.
A local music shop has even donated a brand new guitar.
Is that mine?
Have a go on that.
Oh, that sounds better, doesn't it? I've got this little crap guitar and it's not really good at all. And I'm going for an audition for my busker's license on Friday. Oh,
okay.
To get become a legal busker, like.
Okay. Okay.
You're a star, a new guitar and a Playtex bra. And I know that you'll go far, because you're a star. It's all right, isn't it? All right, off then. See you, folks.
The new guitar might have made all the difference, but its cash value was just too tempting.
I only had a fiver left, yeah?
Where's your guitar?
In pawn. Until Friday, till I get moved 360 clears.
Who with?
At cash converters, as usual.
Blue moon, you saw. All is not lost. He can still use Gary's old guitar for the audition. Without a dream. And he's been working on an idea for a Christmas song.
How's it going? I sell the biggest shoe to get a penny or two. Sell the biggest shoe to get a penny or two. I got Christmas, I got money, I got presents on my mind. Christmas is coming and the goose is getting fat. Please put a penny in Vernon's hat. He's got Christmas, he's got presents, he's got money on his mind. But I've got to write a few more verses to
it. That's not bad,
brilliant.
It's the day of the audition, but a few hours before he's due to perform, disaster strikes. Vernon might have to contend with food poisoning and a dodgy guitar, but the show must go on.
The other one's a lot better, isn't it? The other one sounds a lot better than that. But, like, it should be all right still. It's tuned in, I think.
Just try my best and see if I can pass it.
There's no better way to prepare for the audition than to play for real. The guitar might not be the best, but Vernon has a secret weapon up his sleeve.
Baby, you're beautiful, you gotta die someday. Some bitches never coming back here no more. Clap hands.
The audition is just minutes away.
Get the time, darling. No problem. Can you get the time, though?
The stakes are high. The professionals round the corner are doing brisk business. The council's judges are going to take Vernon away to a secret location.
You won't be able to film the audition, Lord, but it doesn't matter. I'll let you know the outcome. Yeah?
This is it. Will Vernon's improvised blues act impress the judges?
I've got good news. We've got some good news. Yeah, I'm on the approved list of the buskers. I can busk when I phone in and let him know that I'm going to busk. If he gives me permission for that night, if there's a space for me.
I'm on the approved list of buskers and I can busk legally. I passed my audition sort of thing. My harmonica swung it for me. Yeah. I wasn't very good at the guitar playing, but the harmonica swung it for me. If you'd have said you'd have failed, like, I would have been gutted. I would have been absolutely gutted, like. Yeah. But yeah, passed.
With the prospect of a legitimate musical career, the few quid in his pocket can now go towards some early Christmas presents.
That's for my grandson, a colouring book. I'll do for my son. That's the first thing I bought for Christmas.
Vernon's hopes of buying more presents depend on his success as a busker.
Got a bargain with those $3, didn't I?
So he needs to put more work into that Christmas song.
Hello, Trev.
Hello.
Sandy, you're on, Trevor.
Yeah, man. Here's the words, right? Yeah. And this is when you hit the chord.
Yeah. Rod.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, that's brilliant.
Yeah. Go on, start. Christmas. Ready? Yeah. One, two, and one, two, three, four.
It's Christmas time when you've got no cash. You can hit the bins and grab some trash. You got presents, you got money, you got gifts for everyone.
I don't know what Uncle Jerry would have to say about this.
With Christmas just round the corner, Vernon's shopping for festive decorations to spruce up his busking act.
I think I'll get a silver one. I'll do me the job.
What's that for?
Washing up bowl to collect my money in busking. That's just ideal, look. I'll do the job, won't
I? I don't know, I just want to get a couple of Christmas things in my flat.
A generous donation from a big issue buyer has allowed him to reclaim the new guitar.
Yeah, that's brilliant, pal. That's brilliant, sir. That's brilliant, yeah.
99 pence, oh, that's brilliant. Do you know what I'm going to have to do, though, is get a roll of sticky type, you know? I think. Merry Christmas, mate. Thanks a lot, pal. Nice one.
And now he's finally ready to play his first gig as a licensed busker.
That's better.
The world premiere of his Christmas song.
Anything we'll do today, folks? Oh, it's Christmas time and we're oh so skint. Oh, it's Christmas time, take a hint. I got money, I got Christmas, I got presents on my mind. I sell the big issue to get...
Christmas cheer is in short supply tonight. Life will always be a struggle when you're skint.
I want £1.10p. I don't want to go and sell my big issues in Kingsley after. Or seven, I have to do seven in town. And then Kingsley. Any chance of getting a hot chocolate and a chicken milk sandwich off there? So, oh, thanks a lot. Got a bit nippish. Grumbling I am.
Merry. It's going to be another hard Christmas for Vernon. But maybe, with a little help from his friends, it might just be one to remember.
Once more with failing, then.
Yes. Yeah. I got Christmas, I got presents, I got money on my mind. God bless you, pal, for stopping you the first one.
If you find yourself struggling this Christmas, go to bbc.co.uk/hardchristmas or call 08000 934 999.
And the BBC's Hard Christmas season continues at midday tomorrow on Radio 2 with Jeremy Vine and special Christmas messages from listeners to their loved ones serving overseas in the armed forces. Next tonight on BBC One, life's a drag for Dustin Hoffman in our comedy Tootsie.